Welcome back to my channel. So today is another slow cooker Sunday video. I am so excited to share with y'all three more of our favorite crockpot recipes. These are all super good, and I know a lot of times I share crockpot recipes that don't take all day to cook, but these three recipes do take a while to cook. So if you work out of the house, you can put this on in the morning, and by the time you get home, dinner will be done. So those are my favorite, but tonight we're gonna do some teriyaki chicken, and this is actually one of the meals that I like to freeze. I do my chicken, put all of my ingredients in my freezer bag, put it in the freezer, and then whenever I go to put it in my crock pot, I dump it right in while it's still frozen, and then I cook it all day just like that. And then when I get home, all I have to do is make my side and it's ready to go. So I love this one, but today I'm not doing it from frozen just because I want to show y'all all the ingredients that I put into it. It's really simple, so I'm going to go ahead and flip y'all around and show y'all how to make it.
Okay, so for our teriyaki chicken, I'm just going to take some of these chicken tenders. You can use chicken breast, whatever you want to use will work. These are pretty much thawed out, but they are a little bit frozen. I just stick those in the bottom of my crock pot, and then I'm going to do a little bit of garlic, and I like to use this pre-minced garlic, probably that much, almost a spoonful. I don't measure anything, so I will leave a full recipe down below that has exact measurements, but you don't have to follow it to a T. And then the recipe calls for a cup of teriyaki sauce, but I don't have a cup. So this is almost 3/4, maybe 2/3. And I think this will work fine. So I just dumped that right in. And then I don't like my teriyaki chicken super sweet, so I'm gonna do not even 1/4 cup of brown sugar. You can do more, you can do less, whatever you wanna like. Or whatever you want to do. I would just kind of try this out and see what your family likes, and then next time maybe do more or less. And then here I have 1/2 cup of water. So that is that. I'm going to pop a lid on, and then this is going to cook on high just because I'm starting this later in the day. So I'm just going to put it on 6 hours, but I'll check it in about 4 to 5. But if you work out of the house, definitely you can cook this on low all day long. So yeah, we will be back in about 5 hours and check. Okay, so here is our chicken. It is done. I think it's been going maybe 4.5 hours, and I'm just going to kind of shred it with a fork, and then that way all of that chicken, once it's shredded, can sit in this juice. You can take yours out and shred it, but it really is just fork tender. So gonna do this, let this sit in this little juice, and then we will plate this up here in just a minute when everything else is finished. So here is dinner all plated up. I did shred my chicken. You could leave yours whole if you wanted. And then we just paired ours with some rice and some broccoli. I think this is the perfect combination. So we're gonna go eat, but I will leave this chicken recipe linked down below.
So tonight's crock pot recipe, we are gonna throw a roast in the crock pot, and then we are gonna make some like Philly cheesesteak sandwiches out of it. I call them that even though I'm using roast. Whatever, they're super good, super simple, and kind of just a way to switch things up for your roast if you're kind of just sick of eating roast, carrots, potatoes, or whatever. So I love this, and it's really good to have throughout the week. So I'm gonna go ahead and flip y'all around and show y'all how I make it.
Okay, so sorry if y'all hear a movie in the background. Noah is content and happy watching Luca. So anyways, I have a roast in my crock pot, and I've already browned it on both sides, and I did salt and pepper. And now I'm just gonna go and add in some red wine vinegar. I'm kind of just playing around with some flavors today. So that's good on that. And then I'm gonna do some Worcestershire sauce. That is such a hard word to say. This is like one of my favorite flavors, so I really go a little bit heavy-handed on this. And then we are gonna do some Cavender seasonings. Y'all know this combination is my favorite. I do the Cavenders with some onion powder and some garlic powder. So you can do some real garlic in here if you want, but I'm not going to. So this is good. There's a little bit of liquid in the bottom, so I'm just gonna leave that. I'm going to pop the lid on, and this is going to cook on low all day. So I'm hoping at least 8 hours. The longer, the better. Okay, so this has been going all day pretty much, and I'm just going to shred this. It's very, very tender. I'm gonna shred this and then kind of let it sit in this juice for probably 10, 15 minutes. Just let it absorb some of that goodness. And then after that, I'm going to put this on some rolls, some little sub rolls with some provolone cheese. I think that will be really good. So I'll meet y'all back here in just a second and we will assemble our sandwich. Okay, so here is our sandwich. I love how simple this dinner is, and it's great leftovers, so you can have it for lunches during the week. This would be a really easy meal prep. So we just did the meat and cheese, but you could do mushrooms, you could do peppers, onions, whatever you want to add to this. I think you can't go wrong. So we just did ours on some white sub rolls, but whatever you want to use, it will work. This is so good, and the flavor of this meat is really good, so I love that combination. So I will type that out and leave it down below in the description box. So today is Saturday. We're kind of having a chill day, but I'm going to throw some barbecue ribs in the crock pot. I personally don't love ribs, but it is my husband's favorite food. So I know that he's very excited about this. And this is probably one of the easiest rib recipes that you will find. And they are super tender and super delicious. So let's go ahead and let's get started. Okay, so in my crock pot, I have my baby back ribs. These are pretty big, so I cut them in half and I did trim them up just a little bit. You can trim off some of the fat if you want. And then our two ingredients, we are going to do some of this Sweet Baby Ray's barbecue sauce. You can use whatever barbecue sauce you like. This is my favorite, so we always go for it, this one. And I'm just gonna cover this really, really good. I would say probably a cup and a half to 2 cups, but I do have a lot of ribs, so kind of just depends on how much you are cooking. And then you can always go back once this is like halfway through and add more barbecue sauce. And then our second ingredient is a can of Dr. Pepper, which I think is wonderful. Anything with Dr. Pepper in it, I think it's gonna be amazing. So add the whole 12 ounces right into your crock pot, and then we are going to put the lid on this, and I will come back and add some more barbecue sauce later, but I just want to get this going. So this is going to cook all day on low, at least 8 hours, maybe even closer to 10. We will see, but I will come back and check this here in just a little bit. Okay, so I've been gone all day. It's almost 7:30 now. My husband actually already ate some of these for supper, but he said they were really good. So I didn't go in and add more barbecue sauce, but he said it could have used it. So definitely add some more halfway through, but these are super tender, falling straight off the bone. As you can see, here's the bone and there's no meat left on it. So I think that's a really good sign. I think cooking them in your crock pot is a really easy, quick, and great way to do it. So I'm gonna plate these up and then I'll kind of show you an up close of what they look like. So I'll be right back. Okay, so here are these ribs up close. I just wanted you guys to kind of get a better picture. They are fall off the bone, so good, juicy and tender. I just don't think you can go wrong when cooking them in your crock pot. So this is a really good recipe for a big crowd. So maybe even for Christmas, if you wanted to switch things up a little bit. So I will leave the full recipe link down below. Super simple and a really big crowd pleaser. Thank you guys for watching today's video. I hope that you enjoyed it, and I hope you got some crockpot recipe inspiration for this upcoming week. I know it's a busy one, and as always, if you are new to my channel, I would love for you to stick around, so be sure to hit that subscribe button down below. Give this video a big thumbs up if you enjoyed it, and I will see y'all in my next one. Bye, guys.